Seems too horrific to be true, right? But did you know that Squid Game is based on a true story? This may seem unbelievable, but we made an amazing discovery of the true inspiration behind this series. Netflix's latest global phenomenon, Squid Game, is breaking records. Already 142 million households have seen this amazing series. But did you know that Squid Game is inspired by true events? This may seem unbelievable, but we made an amazing discovery of the inspiration behind this series. Don't believe us? What about the story of H.H. Holmes, who built a murder castle where his victims needed to escape? After the killings, he actually sold their organs. Or the story of Carl Panzram, who actually played games with his victims before killing them. That's sick, right? Keep watching to find out the full stories behind these serial killers. First, let's do a small recap of the series. Squid Game is a story of 456 people with one common thing connecting them all: massive, massive debt. These people are recruited and come together in an undisclosed camp, unaware that soon death is waiting for them. The show highlights the economic struggles and class prejudice in South Korea. The mysterious founders of the game, who are presumably rich, pit these people against one another in deadly children's games for a chance to win 45.6 million South Korean won. It shows the sadistic nature of the lengths the rich might go to for entertainment and how the poor will stop at nothing in moments of pure desperation when they have nothing to lose, other than their lives, of course. There are a total of 6 games on the show, including the recruiting round. The first one is a Korean game called Dadaki, where the goal is to flip one tile lane on the ground with another with extreme precision. Then there is the infamous red light, green light, where runners have to freeze from being killed when the light is red or when the giant doll turns to look at them. Other games include Honeycomb, where players carefully try to prize a shape from a Dalgona candy without breaking it. And there is a game called Tug of War, a game of competitive marble racing, glass stepping stones, which is a game of balance, and finally, the name of the show, Squid Game. The final game is an elaborate version of tag with attackers and defenders, where the defense can do whatever is necessary, including pulling, pushing, and ultimately killing to keep the offense from winning. Quite gruesome that you'll turn against your own to survive. It makes you think what humans are capable of at the lowest point, doesn't it? Well, as you may have guessed already, there was only one survivor out of the 456. Don't worry, we won't be spoiling it for you. But doesn't this whole thing sound like a scheme where a serial killer got away with subtly killing 455 people without getting their hands dirty? It sounds familiar because it is true. Throughout history, there have been serial killers who loved playing elaborate games to torture their victims. Let's have a look at some of these gruesome stories. David Parker Ray, or the Toy Box Killer, tended to play with his victims before he eventually murdered them. He transformed a trailer into a soundproof torture chamber. The motorhome was equipped with whips, cattle prods, sex toys, a gynecology chair, and several other devices that he used to torture and subsequently murder 40 victims approximately. His preferred method of killing was searing them with a cattle prod till the victims slowly bled to death by bleeding through the mouth. He was caught when one of his victims, Vigil, miraculously escaped. An FBI investigation then revealed hundreds of snuff films and the belongings of missing women, which led to a life sentence. Ray is believed to have been working since the 1950s in America. Vigil also stated that Ray would play a cassette recording detailing out exactly how he would torture and kill her. While this may not relate to a specific game on the show, it fits right into the whole premise of an elaborate torture chamber or remote location where games were played that resulted in violent, gruesome deaths. A few years later, from 1971 to 1983, another alleged serial killer, Robert Hansen, abducted and assaulted around 30 victims in Alaska. His victims were exotic dancers or prostitutes, and he would release them with a warning to never tell anyone. Later on, his MO changed and he would abduct women between 17 and 41 and fly them out to the Alaskan wilderness. Here, he would strip the women naked and tell them to run as if they were his prey. Once the women began running to survive the ordeal, Hansen would hunt them down with a big game rifle or a hunting knife. Eventually, in 1983, a teenager, Cindy Paulson, managed to escape before he flew her out and contacted the police, leading to his arrest and incarceration. Well, this sounds like a version of the Squid Game between Hansen and his victim in the Alaskan forests, a deadly version of the children's game of tag. Deal Coral, or the Candyman, or Pied Piper as he was called by the media, but offer free candy to children in the early 1970s. He would lure young teens with the pretext of a free ride or a party. Once they climbed into his van, he would abduct them, drive them to his house, and tie them to a torture board made of plywood. He would do his best to lure teen boys and would continue to torture them for days at a time. He had two accomplices, David Brooks and Elmer Henke, and together they harmed nearly 28 males. When the latter fatally shot Coral in 1972, they were caught. This seems like a loose inspiration for the Honeycomb Game, where the contestants were given Dalgona candy with different imprints that they had to cut out. It also takes us back to the very first recruiting game, when the contestants were lured in with money instead of candy, without knowing the danger that they were putting themselves in. But this was nothing compared to who was perhaps the most sadistic killer in history, Carl Panzram. In 1920, he took up work on a ship bound to Angola as a merchant seaman. Once he arrived in Lobito Bay in Angola, he hired six local guides, stating that they would go on a crocodile hunting expedition. But what the guides didn't know was that Carl had other prey on his mind. As their canoe made its way down the crocodile-infested river, Carl shot his crew members dead one by one and continued to feed their corpses to the hungry reptiles lurking right below. This was just one of his many crimes, which included rape, burglaries, and more murders. His first murders were similar to the ones in Angola. In 1918, when Carl was in New York, he hired sailors to work on his yacht that he had bought with his robbery bounty. He proceeded to lull them into a deep slumber with alcohol and then shot all 10 of them dead without any remorse. But the serial killer MO that resonates the loudest with Squid Game is perhaps that of H.H. Holmes. He was a pharmacist who spent his early career as a professional insurance scam artist. He then relocated to Illinois in 1893 to work as a pharmacist. This is where the infamous serial killer built an elaborate murder castle, as he termed it. It was a three-story inn that he secretly transformed into a macabre torture chamber. The only chance of survival his victims had was to escape the labyrinth he had made within the structure. Some rooms were equipped with hidden peepholes, trap doors, soundproof padding, and gas lines, whereas others had secret passages, hallways, and ladders that ended up nowhere. They were all dead ends. There was also a grease chute that led directly to Holmes's murder lair in the basement. Here he had a surgical table, a furnace, and even a medieval torture rack. Before and during the Chicago World Fair, the specific event for which Holmes had uprooted his life as a scammer to move to Illinois, he led more than 27 women to his lair. He then asphyxiated them with poison gas and took them down to the basement to perform terrible experiments on them. The elaborate maze-like interiors he had crafted made sure no one could escape and that no one would find them. After murdering the women, he would dispose of their corpses in his furnace or skin them and then sell the skeletons to medical schools. While he was fulfilling his murderous passion, he also worked insurance scams to fund his hobby. He was finally caught when one of his co-conspirators tipped the police as he was scornful that Holmes had failed to deliver his promised amount. When Holmes was convicted of murdering four people, he confessed to 27 more killings before he was hanged in 1896. Holmes's concept of a murder castle seems to have inspired the whole premise of the mysterious Squid Game Island, where the only chance for survival was to win all the games. While the games themselves may have been inspired by childhood games, their deadly twist was surely inspired by some of these sick serial killers who love to play a game with their victims to mentally and physically torture them before killing them. Just like Holmes sold the skeletons of some of his victims to medical colleges, in Squid Game, the henchmen coerced a doctor to harvest the organs of dead contestants to sell it in the Chinese black market. Of course, this was without the frontman's knowledge, and when he found out, no spoilers here. Do you think the games these serial killers played inspired some portions of Squid Game? Do you have the stories of any more serial killers to share? Comment down below. If you enjoyed the video, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Stay tuned.